red late models. Field's been given the one to go signal. We are just about ready to get down to it. 12 laps to go. First Bourlon Performance Heat Race. Top four go on to the big show. The winner starts on the pole for the big show tonight. Scott Moonquist drives the lead in turn one. Skip one close to the inside the race. Greg Smith back to the fourth and final transfer spot. Wayne Hummel, Red for the big show tonight. Coming home in second spot in car number 31, the Curtis Equipment GRT Monte Carlo out of Georgetown, Tennessee for Skip Harp. He'll line up for the main event tonight on the inside of row three. Coming home in the third spot, the 1996 Hav-A-Tampa National Champion of the Double Zero Automobile, the Christopher Trucking and Farms GRT Monte Carlo for the Southern Gentleman, Freddie Smith. He'll start on the inside of row five for tonight's feature event. And coming home in the fourth and final transfer spot in car number 53 out of Brasstown, North Carolina, in the English Mountain Springwater, GRT Ford Mustang, the Tar Heel Tiger Ray Cook will line up on the inside of row. Starting procedures for the Hav-A-Tampa Dirt Late Models. Drivers have been instructed, those two front row cars, to set an unsteady even pace. Through turns three and four all the way down to the orange cone. They cannot accelerate until the green light comes on. Approaching the cone. The penalty for jumping, a double foul restart, is one row. Everybody must race to the outside of the cone. Penalty for jumping, a single foul restart, is to the back of the pack. Dale McDowell, the pole position. Rick Eckert alongside. Bring him off the fourth turn. Green flag out. second is Jimmy Mars in third. First 12-lap consolation race. Kevin Hull with the win in our second 12-lap Moral Performance Heat Race. The defending Hav-A-Tampa National Champion out of Rossville, Georgia, the 17M automobile. The Glenn's Auto Parts, Reinhardt Trucking, GRT, Monte Carlo. How about a nice round of applause for Dale McDowell? He'll go from the outside front row for the big show tonight. Kevin Hull in the second spot in car number 24. He'll line up on the outside of row three for the main event tonight. Out of North Pennsylvania, the Rain Vest Rocket Ford Mustang, Rick Eckert. Coming home in the third spot in car number 28M from Elk Mound, Wisconsin, the Barker Stores, Masterbuilt Monte Carlo. He'll line up on the outside, the fifth row, Jimmy Mars. And coming home in the fourth spot in the 6M automobile, he'll start on the outside of row seven for the main event tonight. From Batesville, Arkansas, the Monday Trucking GRT House Car Grand Prix, Wendell Wallace. Earl Pearson Jr. on the inside of row two, Bill Benson Ford, Mustang outside of him. Dusty Christenberry out of Knoxville, Tennessee in the Armstrong Refrigeration GRT Grand Prix. Field bunching up over in turn number three is Billy Ogle Jr. and Ronnie Johnson break the field around in turn number four, approaching the orange cone. Team race out of Knoxville, Tennessee, and the Vanover Concrete Finishers, P&J Builders, Lawyer, Monte Carlo. How about a nice round of applause for Billy Ogle Jr. Billy Ogle Jr. will line up for the main event on the inside of row number two. Coming home in second spot in the 5J automobile. He'll start the main event tonight from the inside of the fourth row from Chattanooga, Tennessee, in the actual race product, Lawyer Grand Prix, Ronnie Johnson. Coming home in the third spot, car number one from Jacksonville, Florida, the Doug Benson Ford Rocket Mustang. He'll line up for the main event tonight on the inside of row number six, Earl Pearson Jr. And taking the fourth and final transfer spot at the C3 car, he'll line that machine up on the inside of row eight for the big show tonight. From Knoxville, Tennessee, in the Armstrong Refrigeration GRT Grand Prix, Dusty Christenberry. Start of our fourth 12-lap Borla Performance Heat Race. Dan Sleeper on the pole position. Outside, Marshall Green in the 89. Green will battle with the try number one. Marshall Green in on the outside. Francis makes it 3 wide. Marshall Green out in front of car number 89 and Sleeper. Francis and car number 15 in the green. Driving the fourth and final transfer spot. Sleeper looks to the inside, off the turn two. Pull to the deck, ball into Marshall Green. They're wheel to wheel off the four turn. Francis driving in 3-1. Marshall Green will hold off the inside. Trailing the turn one. Sleeper still on the inside of Francis. Green is going to call his advantage in the turn three. Marshall Green on the outside. Sleeper right there on the inside as they go into turn number one. Steve Francis right there on the top two on the inside. For Anthony White in turn two. Caution flag coming out off the Speedway. Caution flag out. Anthony White. Signal White neutral. Spot Mike Gold in seventh. And eighth will be Anthony White, who will go to tail the field for the restart in car number two. So once again, down the field, getting the one-to-go signal. Marshall Green on the point. He's had his hands full with last night's winner, our second-place car, Dan Sleeper in the S9 car. Sleeper working to the inside of Marshall Green. Steve Francis even working a car width below Sleeper down on the inside from the third spot. Back action, Marshall Green on the point. Leads Dan Sleeper, Steve Francis, and David Payne on the fourth turn. Sleeper again dives for the bottom as he looks underneath Marshall Green. Green from the low there. Pulls the lead down the back straightaway, but Sleeper charging hard down on the bottom. Here comes Francis on the inside of the team car. Enterprises lawyer Monte Carlo out of Dalton, Georgia. He'll line up for the main event on the outside of row two. How about a nice round of applause for Marshall Green? Coming home in the second spot in the S9 car out of Pewaukee, Wisconsin. Last night's main event winner in the Performance Roofing Systems, Rayburn Monte Carlo, Dan Sleeper. Dan Sleeper will start on the outside of row four, the eighth starting spot tonight. Last night, Dan Sleeper won from the 12th starting position. And starting in that 12th starting position tonight will be our third place finisher in heat race number four, in car number 15 out of Ashland, Kentucky, in the Valvoline Oil Rocket, Monte Carlo, the Kentucky Colonel, Steve Francis. And rounding out the Sweet 16, our fourth place finisher in car number eight from Murphy, North Carolina, in the Payne Tire GRT Monte Carlo, it will be David Payne. So very quickly, he is getting the one to go signal. Wayne Hommel on the pole position. Steve Smith alongside. Rick Norris on the inside of the second row. His driver Ronnie Payne in the 8R car. Top three go on to the main event. Field rolling off the fourth turn towards the orange cone. Rick Clark. On the inside of the second row, outside of him, the 11B is Stacy Bowles. Bowles moving up from the outside of the third row with Ronnie Payne out of the race. He'll move up to the outside of row two. Roger Best on the inside of the third row. Johnny Chastain outside of him, the 00C. Here they come, rolling off the fourth turn. Wayne Hommel and Steve Smith battle wheel to wheel through turn 22. Smith with the advantage down the back straightaway. Hommel working the inside, trying to make the handstand. Steve Smith by the half garland at the front stand. Hommel still working his inside the second spot. Rick Morris running the third.
Wayne Hommel will finish in the second spot in the H2 car.
And third will move the first in of Rick Torres. Finish in car number three out of Powell, Tennessee, for the Armstrong Refrigeration. Rayburn Monte Carlo. How about a nice round of applause for Steve Smith? He'll start tonight's main event from the 17th starting spot. Coming home in second in the H2 car out of Newport, Tennessee, the Stowers Cat Rental Warrior, Monte Carlo. It will be Dwayne Hommel. He'll line up in the 19th starting spot. And coming home in the third spot in car number 15 in from Kingsport, Tennessee, the Don Smith Ford TNT Ford Mustang, Rick Norris. He'll line up 21st on the grid. Field getting the one to go signal. Donnie Moran up on the pole position. Rex Ritchie alongside, waiting for him in the 21K automobile. John Chastain on the inside of row three. Mike Dahl alongside him in the 17G. Green flag. No. Donnie Moran will line up to the main event from the 18th starting spot. Coming home in second in car number 38 from Greenville, Georgia, in the Giles Industries Warrior Grand Prix. Rex Ritchie, he'll line up on the outside of row 10 and rounding out the top three. CB3 from Knoxville, Tennessee, the Christenberry Trucking and Farms GRT Monte Carlo. Clayton Christenberry, he'll line up for the main event from the 22nd starting spot. Thank you. Tennessee, Doc Smith Ford, TNT Mustang. Please welcome Rick Norris. We get row number 10 on the outside in car number 38 from Rainbow, Georgia, driving the Giles Industries Warrior Grand Prix. Let's hear it for the Rainbow Redhead Rex Ritchie. Starting 19th tonight in the extreme level wheel from Newport, Tennessee, the Sour Scandrel Warrior Monte Carlo. Please welcome Dwayne Howell. Starting 18th, we car number 99 from Bradstreet, Ohio, currently 8th in the Hav-A-Tampa Points Championship with one win on the season. Back coming here in the Tonic Motor Speedway. How about a nice round of applause for Tony Moran? Master of the referee. On the inside of the ninth row, car number 3 from Powell, Tennessee. Driving the Oxford Refrigeration, regular Monte Carlo. Let's hear it for Steve Smith. On the outside of row number 8, driving car number 8 out of Murphy, North Carolina. In the paint for the coach, David Payne. Starting 15th, Tennessee 3 on the wheel out of Knoxville, Tennessee, driving the Armstrong Refrigeration GRT Grand Prix. Well, a nice round of applause for Dusty Christenberry. On the outside, row number 7, driving the 6M automobile, currently 3rd in the Hav-A-Tampa Points Championship with 5 victories on the year. And one of those 5 victories coming right here. The Atomic Motor Speedway earlier this year. The 1999 Hav-A-Tampa National Championship runner-up in the Hyundai Trucking GRT House Car Grand Prix. Let's hear it for Wendell Wallace. Starting on the inside of row number 7, car number 53 out of Brasstown, North Carolina, currently 6th in the Hav-A-Tampa Points Championship. Here in the Atomic Motor Speedway, 2 victories on the season in the English Mountain Springwater GRT Ford Mustang. Let's hear it for the Tar Heel Tiger, Ray Cook. Row number 6 in car number 15 out of Asheville, Kentucky, currently 2nd in the Hav-A-Tampa Points Championship. Just 46 points out of the point lead. Driving the Valvoline Oil Rocket, Monte Carlo, with 4 wins this season. How about a nice round of applause for the Kentucky Colonel, Steve Branson. Florida, 1997, Hav-A-Tampa, Rookie of the Year, driving the Dunn Benson Ford Rocket Mustang. Please welcome Earl Pearson Jr. In row number 5 on the outside, car number 28M out of Elkbound, Wisconsin. We're in the top list 100 a couple weeks ago down in Batesville, Arkansas, currently 9th in the Hav-A-Tampa Points standings. Driving the Parker Stores, Bastersville, Monte Carlo. Let's hear it for Jimmy Marr. On the inside of row number 5 in the 00 automobile, the 1996 Hav-A-Tampa National Champion, your 2nd place finisher last night, currently 5th in the point standings out of Knoxville, Tennessee. Driving the Christenberry Trucking Farms GRT Monte Carlo, let's hear it for the Southern Gentleman, Freddie Smith. Yeah! Season on the pole position. Defending Hav-A-Tampa champion Dale McDowell to his outside. They'll bring the field off the fourth turn. Here they come. Been turned out. We'll look for the green this time by Scott Bloomquist on the pole position. Dale McDowell to his outside. Billy Obo Jr. Marshall Green in row two. Here they come. Green flies up. Thank you. Joe Greenwood to get back to the turn on the front straightaway. Once again, everybody must race to the outside of the orange cone. You can see it's been put up high on the racetrack. If anybody can get into unfair advantage in that fourth turn on the restart. Scott Woodward will bring the field around for the restart. He'll have a balance second. One, two, three, third. We're back to the fourth. Back to the start. Scott Lundquist out in front. Dale McDowell breathing down his tailpipe from the second spot in the 17M automobile. Marshall Green in third. Ronnie Johnson on the move from first spot. Rick Eckert running fifth. Sixth is Linda Wallace. Dan Sleeper from ninth to seventh during that last green flag period. Billy Oval Jr. comes back to eighth. Jimmy Marsh ninth. Steve Francis to tenth. Speedway. Signal. Wayne Kiefer, the only car that is a lap down. Kiefer two laps down. Skip Art beats Scott Bluequist back to the stripe to remain on the lead lap in car number 31. 31 laps in the books. One lap past the halfway point. Scott Bluequist, Dale McDowell, Ronnie Johnson, Wendell Ross, and Dean Kiefer. Ronnie Johnson going to the back of the pack for the restart. Kiefer still the only car allowed in the door. Ronnie Johnson and Wayne Hobble will go by the 31 car. Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, down here in the winner's circle, Scott Bloomquist is standing home. I'm going to wait for him to climb out of the Miller Brothers car, Warrior Ford bus.
Where he was fast at on the racetrack, because the top come in for a little while, and then we put him back down on the bottom, and he seemed to have him covered by about 2/10 on the bottom, and we seen Sleeper coming from the back, him and Wendell both, so we had to try both of their lines up and down the racetrack.
You know, it's just one of them deals, you got to go out and search the racetrack all over.
Well, I know you're getting ready to head up to Eldora for the World 100, and this has got to give you some good momentum for that. I know the one you're really looking forward to is that Million to Win deal.
Yeah, that Million to Win, it's going to be a race that we have all the racing fans can come out.
Time.
Steering wheel coming off. He's in and home. The engine shut down, and he's getting set to come out of the car now, ladies and gentlemen. Let's welcome him to the winner's circle for the 9th time this season. Here he comes, ladies and gentlemen, Scott Bloomquist. Scott Bloomquist winning his 3rd Hav-A-Tampa main event here at Atomic Motor Speedway in his Hav-A-Tampa career. We'll get him up here on the winner's podium where everybody can see him down here in the infield as we get into the Hoosier Tire winner's circle. Scott getting the right hand on custom race engines. Boy, they did the job for you tonight. Looks like you are really making ground on your 4th Hav-A-Tampa championship. 9th win of the season.
You know, it really feels good. It's good to win near home again. You know, we've not won here in a while, and a lot of these guys are running really good everywhere we go, and this place is especially tough. We've just had a lot of help this year, and a lot of hardworking boys, and Bob and Barb Miller have been great with us, helping us get these engines fresh and keeping us going. You know, that's just a big team effort here, and I appreciate all my sponsors.
Well, you've won the last 4 out of 5 races. Didn't quite tie that record of 4 in a row, but a good 5th-place finish last night. The top 5s keep coming. Tell us a little bit about the race tonight. It looked like once you got into lap traffic, Dale was able to pull up alongside of you a couple times.
Well, I think I cut my tires up too much because they'd fire off pretty good, and then after about 3 laps, I'd feel them start slowing down. We had to search around on the racetrack quite a bit. The car handled super, though. You know, getting the lead on those starts was very important, and, you know, it was really quite that much.
Well, Scott, 4 races left in the season, coming up with some big $20,000 to win races, and, of course, the shootout, $53,000 to win. When do you feel like your point lead is comfortable?
You know, you really can't, because you could have something break or something happen on a racetrack and have a couple of DNFs, and we've had a few this year. That's what put us in the position we were in and where we're having to fight back for it. So you really just have to keep up what we're doing, you know, and not take any chances. Last night we had a couple opportunities there that we had to back off, and, you know, we just weren't right last night. Come back, got it right tonight. You just got to take what you can get, but, you know, you just got to keep your car running excellent.
Well, Scott, congratulations. Celebrate your 9th win of the season. Let's give him another nice round of applause. Scott Bloomquist, your winner.